Hey, brothers and sisters, I just wanted to make another quick video. And the last two videos, I skipped on several topics. I always do that. I just want to say this, and I want to make this a separate video. All of you guys who are running to and fro, trying to calculate the day of the rapture and see when the rapture is going to be so you can escape from your horrible little plush little Western world life, I ask you to think about all the people in the world who've never even heard the gospel. I want you to think about all the little children in countries like the Philippines, like in all those pictures. I know that you probably didn't. I know that when I make a video about the rapture warning 2,000 people watching, and I make a video with a report and slideshow of the feeding programs of the orphanage, like 200 people watch it. What do you think the Lord thinks about that? The cold-heartedness and the selfishness of people. And talking about they can't wait to see the Lord. I think that when I read the Bible, I see that it says we'll be ashamed before the Lord, and that he will our whole life, you know, will be exposed there. There's nothing hidden that will not be revealed. And then when you're standing up there and the Lord's like, what have you been doing? Well, I've been spending the last 10 years calculating the rapture and listening to exaggerated news stories on YouTube and how everything's a biblical fulfillment. And yeah, and I've been patting myself on the back and saying I'm saved, and I've been caught up in the bandwagon effect of a cult, a personality on YouTube or in some preacher on TBN or whatever it is. And then I'm standing before the Lord and I have done absolutely squat nothing. Well, I gave my tithes to my church. Yeah, and the church, guess what? They built new padded pews and they put new carpet in the church and they made a nice sanctuary. And they got out there and smiled and loved people all the way to hell and never gave the gospel. So the harvest that you reaped from the money that you gave to your padded pew museum and people-pleasing palaces, I mean nothing with the Lord. Jesus was born in a manger. King Herod was born in a palace. The Antichrist will live in opulence. Look at the way the Pope lives and the way the Pope dresses and all the extravagance of a lot of the preachers from TV, the prosperity preachers. Benny Hinn has a private jet, all these kind of things, whatever these people are doing, I don't know. All of these things. And then there's Jesus, born in a manger, rode on the colt, the fold of a donkey into Jerusalem on Palm Sunday. Was beaten and crucified and all the things that the Lord suffered and the apostles suffered. I think you need to go back and read Luke 21:36. There's lots of people keep asking me, I hope I'm kind of worthy. John the Baptist gave us the answer. Because when John the Baptist came preaching and said, repent for the kingdom of heaven is at hand and all that, and then the people said, well, what must we do? All these people said, you know, what must we do? And he said, this is the simplest way, the simplest part, he said. He gave lots of details, but he told them, bear fruit in keeping with repentance. Bear fruit in keeping with repentance. Have you borne any fruit? Have you borne any fruit? Because Jesus said, store up your treasures in heaven and not on earth, where thieves can break in and moths can eat it and it can rust and get bad. But the things that you store up in heaven will never grow old. It will never be lost. It can never be stolen because it's stored up with God in heaven. And when the rapture happens, if you make it, if you're kind of worthy and you make it, then we're at the judgment seat of Christ, the bema seat of Christ, and he will weigh everything you've done. And he'll say unto you, oh, you helped build padded pews at a church that is not even part of my church. They're busy telling people all kinds of flowery things. It's not my gospel. As a matter of fact, that's the spirit of Antichrist, a new age spirit, a demon spirit. And you've given money to help this demon spirit drag more people into the pit of hell. All that's going to be burned up is hay, wood, and stubble. Brothers and sisters, I'm gonna go now, and I'm praying for all you guys who run to and fro. I'm praying for all you guys who are a mile wide and an inch deep, and you're on the bandwagon effect of rapture, of escapism. There is going to be a pre-tribulation rapture, but the Lord told us to pray that we'd be kind of worthy to escape. We need to bear fruits and keep in repentance. We need to, Jesus said, blessed is the servant when his master comes, he finds he's working. Matthew chapter 25. As Jesus even did himself, he said, he told Mary and Joseph, don't you know I'll be about my father's business? So the question is, you know, just like Jesus told the people when he went in the temple in John chapter 8, he said, I do the deeds of my father. You do the deeds of your father. And your father is the devil. And he was a liar from the beginning. And he's the father thereof. He can't tell the truth and he can't do the truth because he's a liar and the father thereof. So Jesus said you can tell a tree by the fruit it bears. So look at yourself. The Bible says judge yourself so God doesn't have to. Examine yourself. The Bible is a, James tells us the Bible is a mirror. Look into that mirror and look at the fruit you bear. Stop looking for the rapture and escaping. And look at the fruit you have. That's what the Lord's going to be looking at. When you get to heaven, if you make it and you go in the rapture, or you die and leave this world and you make it into heaven, there's eternity. Eternity to deal with about rewards and lack thereof and all of that to be ashamed. The Bible says we'd be ashamed before the host of heaven with what we've done in this life. Do you understand this is eternal consequences, what you've done in your life? Not just being saved. That's the downfall and the wickedness of this greasy grace gospel. They just keep repeating and repeating and repeating about being born again and never go beyond day one. They're still newborn babies. God didn't call you to be a newborn baby, but to be a mature stature of a man or woman in Christ, to be in the fullness of Christ. Now get out of the baby bed. You're a great big old grown person wallowing around in a baby bed, wearing a diaper, and looking for somebody on YouTube, and especially the number one most popular guy on YouTube. They're looking for him to give him a little breast milk. Baby feet, spoon feed us, tell us we're going to heaven, tell us how that we're saved. Let's repeat that for 25 years. You get tickling your ears while the world's going to hell. The world is starving, the world is dying, the world is full of evil. And Jesus said, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. All of this darkness around you and you're hiding your lamp under a bushel. Jesus said, no one lights a lamp and puts it under a bushel. You know, a city on a hill cannot be hid. And what are you doing? You're hiding your little light and just, ooh, look at me, I'm saved, look at me, I'm saved, I'm going to heaven, I'm going to heaven, I'm going to heaven. Thank you, my YouTube preacher for telling me how great I am and then telling me all this exaggerated news that the rapture is going to be tomorrow, or he doesn't say that, I take that back, that the tribulation is going to begin tomorrow, but I'm saved. Brothers and sisters, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent. Repent. If my people who are called by my name would turn from their wicked ways, would repent and turn from their wicked ways. 2 Chronicles 7:14. I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sins. And I will heal their land. If my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways. Christians, turn from your wicked ways. Repent. Repent. Repent.